morning. I'm presenting on behalf of Lisa Marie. Unfortunately, she fell ill, so she's my MSc student. This is her first year of her study, so I'll be focusing not on the results because it's kind of preliminary. I'll be focusing on where we're going to and why are we looking at the things that we're looking at. So what is mealiness? Mealiness is a diatextual disorder which normally occurs with the consumer. So it's unfavorable, and in any consumer study, mealiness is the most disliked consumer thing that they have. Why is it there? A lot of studies have been done on the why, and normally longer-term storage reduces it. The shorter the storage period, the more mealiness we get during ripening. And interestingly enough, it's also found that there's a loss of cell adhesion, and that's why we find mealiness. Cells actually literally slide over each other, so you'd never bite through the cells to get juiciness. And this has also been confirmed with X-ray CT scans. We can see that in the top one where it's mealy, there are a lot more pore spaces, and the cells have moved away from each other. Just the background to the study, why are we doing what we're doing? So this was a previous study done by Rudolph, and also there was another study done where they showed that the canopy position actually plays a role. So it's not only the storage period, this actually starts already in the canopy. Mm-hmm. That inside fruit, once they ripen, they are a lot less mealy than the outside canopy fruit, whether it's the west or the middle west side of the canopy. Then what we thought was, okay, can we make outside fruit non-mealy? Because is it a canopy position effect, or is it a temperature or a radiance effect? So we put caps over the fruit, and we found a lot less mealy fruit, the ones that were covered, that were under the shade, from December onwards till harvest. Then this is where Lisa Marie's study comes in. So why do some fruit get mealy and not? And when is this induced? And can we really stop mealiness altogether? So we looked at the time of mealiness induction and understanding when and why. And then also we were looking towards shade netting trials to see whether one can reduce the mealiness effect without influencing the color development. So her first trial focuses on the time of the mealiness induction, so from the 1st of December, or 14 weeks before harvest, every 2 weeks we put caps on, and then afterwards, we harvest all of them, we store them all the same, and then we check mealiness. So the reason why we store only for 8 weeks is, between 6 and 8 weeks is when we get the maximum mealiness levels. And then we ripen them for 4, 7, and 11 days. The reason for that is sometimes we get different ripening rates, and we don't know, mealiness during ripening goes up and then goes down again, so one can't have a snapshot of only one day. You have to look at the whole thing. And then why these differences in time would influence them, or how these differences in times would influence them, we would look at the structure of each cell during X-ray CT, like I've shown you in the first slide, to look how the pore sizes are influenced by the shading effect over time. And then we're also looking at the cell wall enzymes during these shading differences to see why these cells are separated in some treatments and others not. Okay, then the second trial, this is a follow-up from that one, is to look at the different irradiance levels and temperature levels to see whether that influences mealiness. And literally we're going to shade certain parts, branches, and then again from the first week of December onwards, and we're looking at white shade net and black shade net, and the reason behind that is to look at hopefully different temperatures that we create through the different shade netting. So we'll measure temperature and irradiance, fruit surface temperature and irradiance under the shade net. And then we have different densities, like 20%, 40%, 60% shade nets, and then a control with no shading to determine what the effect is of the different percentage of irradiance and temperature. So that hopefully will answer the question on what is the influence of temperature and irradiance and the level of it. So we hope to isolate the induction stage of mealiness, and reduce the environmental stress that causes mealiness. And hopefully we also get clearer answer of when it is important for blush color development not to lose that altogether, because we still want blush color pairs. Thank you very much.